Solstice Ball is around the corner. This is a good opportunity to forget the war. What are you preparing? Then set up a large stone circle to dance. All clothed. Shifty eyes. Draw a dolman card. It wouldn't be bad. Here is some money to set up the ball. Draw a refectory card, which would be very nice. Let's have a huge feast. All the alcohol. Or we have no money. I think I'd like a dolman so I can bump up how quickly we can learn that. Yeah. Also, you notice that we've now got I mean, technically that's meant to be some sort of portal up there, but we've got grass all over the ground as well, which is lovely. You only need two more levels to get the house leprechaun. Right, it's time. Oh, actually, before we go. Counselor's office. Magical hat. Active teachers in this room have a chance of improving their pedagogy. We are going with that. As much as I want the elemental dojo or the council office, this is way too useful. Where is your room? Pop. We are now capable of removing negative traits, of making them better teachers. Our teachers are... We need a couple more places for our teachers to rest, but generally speaking, this is actually awesome. But it's time, Chad. It is time. Let us go. Would you like to send an expedition to this dungeon? Yes, yes, I would. All right. Choose four students to send to the dungeon. Position them and choose which spell they will use. No matter what happens, you will keep the loot gathered, but danger levels will increase as you explore. Do not hesitate to flee the dungeon when the opportunity arises if you wish to save your students. Okay, you can come back later. Skill total. I guess. Courageous, plus one damage to monsters. Unbreakable, increased health. Courageous. Got insect swarm, beast magic before combat. This student has a 4% chance of paralyzing for one round and weakening all enemies in the same file by 1 point. Heals the other students in the file for one health point each time that student acts. An offensive spell that inflicts 2 damage on the closest enemy gains 2 power after each attack for the duration of the combat. Increases all mana and gold gains in the dungeon by 10%. Blood Pact, Demonology. After acting, gives the other students in the row a 30% chance of acting immediately. Life Drain, an offensive spell that inflicts 6 damage to the closest enemy and heals the cast of 6 without exceeding original value. That's actually quite nice, Necromancy 3. Let's go for Necromancy. Oh, wow, critical hit. Grants a 50% chance of doubling all damage dealt and all shields created by your spells. After acting, an offensive spell that inflicts... we've got Magical Armor, increases health. Okay, let's see. If I select someone, for example, if I select you and pop you there, active spell is Life Drain, passive skills is Insect Swarm, Critical Hit, Blood Pact, Resource Transfer. Wow, okay. So kind of want as many skills as I possibly can have then, yeah. Example, you. Wild Fury, an offensive skill that inflicts 2 damage on the closest enemy. Life Drain, Necromancy, an offensive spell that inflicts 2 damage to the closest enemy. Or Magic Bolt, an offensive spell. But you don't have... Okay, Healing Herbs, Insect Swarm, Critical Hit, Blood Pact, Resource Transfer. I'm not sure I can easily see which ones are orphans at this point, I'm afraid. So I actually don't know. As much as you're insisting that I should. Oh, you will passively heal over time because you're a werewolf. Magical Ink gives a 20% chance of creating a random spell scroll before each encounter. Let's have a look through all of the abilities. Protective Runes grants 9 shield points before each combat. An offensive spell that inflicts 8 damage to the closest enemy with a 40% chance of paralyzing them. Wow. Heroic Armor. Lowers all incoming damage by 1. Retaliation gives a 10% chance of acting instantly after receiving damage. Okay, I can see how you would want to build a very powerful character then with these. I can see how this would all pile in. Damage dealt to monsters. Sacred Shield, an offensive spell that increases the shield of all the students in the group by 3. After 10 rounds, triggers a random known spell instead. Alright, so we want our front line. I kind of like the idea of having high-level necromancers in the front, because they will be able to heal themselves. Yeah, I didn't realize this got so intense with battle. Oh yeah, and you get one dungeon. I think there are sometimes you can get two, but one dungeon per map. Which is why I've been saving it up, because, you know, you only get one chance at this. But I think, Zachary, you're going to be on the front lines. Insect Swarm, critical hit, so before combat, you got a 1% chance of paralyzing for one round. You've also got critical hit, blood pact, and resource transfer. So critical hit, 50% chance of doubling all damage dealt, and all shields created by your spells. After acting, gives the other students 10% chance on the same row. And I think that's honestly the best move for us. Do we have someone else with high options? I mean, this one's not bad. In fact, you've got healing, so let's pop you there. Healing herbs. Heals other students in the file for 1 health point each time that student acts. So you naturally heal. You'll heal yourself and you'll heal others in the file. If I pop you in there. I don't think you're the best person for putting in the back, though. What I would love is people who can pop down shields. Around 6 shield points before each combat. I think that's only to you, though. What I need is someone with Sacred Shield. Offensive spell that increases the shields of all the students in the group by 1. We needed that up higher. Oh, wait. Let's have a look for Sacred Magic. Alright. Now, you got Paralysis, an offensive spell that inflicts 6 damage to a closest enemy with a 30% chance of stunning them, or an offensive spell that increases the shields of all students in the group by 3. After 10 rounds, triggers a random known spell instead. I think I'd want to go with the shield. Is Emma better than Samuel in the same spot? Okay, I need to check who you were looking at. Oh, right, okay. You might be right. You've got 3 critical hits, so 30% chance of acting immediately. Gives the other students in the row 40% chance of acting. Looking that actually might be a much better move. 20% chance of doubling damage. You would do 2 less damage each hit, but you'd have increases mana and gold gains in the dungeon by 10%, plus heals other students in the file for 2 health points. I think you might be right, actually. Emma may be much better just because of the herbalism. But Samuel does have a HP boost, which is nice. Whereas Emma only has extra damage. That 5 health. That can really turn things around. I think the 1 healing is good enough, but it was a good call to question me on. Honestly, I wish more of my werewolves had some better skills in this, frankly. I was really hoping that we'd have a couple of those out there. Let's put up skill totals. Sabrina is pretty strong. Kathy is actually pretty strong too. healing herbs, 4% chance of paralyzing. But I'm not sure on that one. I think Anton would be a better choice there. Now, Anton being a werewolf, I think, does heal. I'm not actually totally sure about that. Wild Fury starts off doing 2 damage. Gains 2 power after each attack for the duration of combat. Now, when it says duration combat, I assume it just means that one fight. I would prefer them doing a lot of damage and healing themselves to that, personally. But I don't know, I haven't had enough experience with these fights to really know how long the fights last for. Probably great for a backliner. Yeah, no, that's definitely true. The paralysis skill is really solid. We've got a nice protective magic skill there. But let's have a look around the different things. So we've got insect swarms there. Sabrina is actually quite a powerful one, I think. Got herbalism. Who's the best at herbalism? Only a 3. Though we've got some that have got a nice spread. But for example, yeah, we could go with Wild Fury. Because if you can get druidism up high enough, then it starts to be really dangerous, because this starts at 4, and then the next attack will be 8, then the next attack will be 12. This one scales well, as long as you have it at a nice high level to start with. Heroism lowers all incoming damage, gives protection, gives a 10% chance of retaliating, gets a shield there. And these are nice, but they're not super amazing. Do we have temporal magic at all for anyone? There's a 20% chance of completely dodging an attack's damage. Oh, that's quite cool. Demonology. Critical hit, necromancer, demonology. And then finally got runes, potions. I think ultimate. Let's have a look at enchantments. Have we got some really high enchantments? We do. They've also got a 20% chance of doubling their damage. They've got protective magic, but that one doesn't really pan out for us. Those are active skills. This one's not terrible. Potions, it would be lovely if I had some more potions, frankly.
Looking dapper.
But sadly, we do not. Got a little bit of ink there, but... Looks like Splat missed out on declining the dungeon. The dungeons are super fun, yeah. Hi, Atrobilius. Hi, Avak. So glad I've managed to catch 2 hats. Or what might be the tail end of your stream. Rules at work don't let me listen to you when I'm working anymore, and that means I've missed a lot of your streams. Oh, no worries, mate. The VODs are always there for you. But thank you for dropping by, mate. I've missed saying your name. Hi, Alice. Just drop by. How goes the magic cult? Going quite well. Rune shield is pretty strong, yeah. Now, that's the thing. Having that grants 9 shield points before combat. I think we're going to go with Magdalene. And I want you to paralyze. You've got retaliation, critical hit, resource transfer. Most of us have got resource transfer, actually. This is quite nice. I think this will be it. This is our group. We're going to use secret magic to add shields to everyone. You're going to try and paralyze. Then you two, the heavy hitters, will just try to life drain them down. Now, the only one that I'm a little bit uncertain of, I'm going to be honest, is Fanny Devil, oh my lord, Wild Fury, because that could stack so aggressively at the back. If I had Wild Fury back here... Or here. Like, don't add shield to anyone, but just try to alpha them down. And this is the one that I would want for it as well. That being said, maybe dropping it by 1 point so that I'd have a stronger insect swarm. And you'd have a decent chance of creating magical link as well. I think we would drop you in exchange for this. Can I... Oh, can you replace Nick with Mag and swap out Mag for Fanny? What? I remember last time we fought a dungeon, we got screwed by one of the bosses because too much HP. Fanny's better than Molly, you'd say. Okay, well, we'll go with Fanny then because of the much more significant stacking. Okay, I think this is good. Let's start the adventure. Sewers. The sewers in this ancient city are filled with treasures, but also with monsters who have made it their home. You must be careful and watch your step. Forward! There is a pile of bones in the middle of the room. On it sits a white goonie pig with red eyes. It seems peaceful, nibbling on pieces of grass that have grown amidst the bones. You are unsure, but this could be a mimic. A what? Boss battle. Ancient marsh dragon. Level 10. Draw the card skull. Draw the card sword in the stone. Oh right, a shape-shifting creature. Let's watch for a sudden attack. The group's total in beast magic is of at least 7. I don't think it is. Ancient marsh dragon level 1. We could probably rid it of its curse with a ritual and turn it back into a nice little cute goonie pig. We can get the goonie pig. This red stare is worrisome. Let's avoid it. If the regular goonie pig, too bad. It shouldn't look so intimidating. Ah, no, we'll get the goonie pig. Should we keep going? Yes, forward. So the skills that we've got are going to give us an advantage in certain things. So many bloodstains in this area. We could follow them or avoid them. Of course we'll follow them. Or yes, avoid them. This seems safer. Increase the threat level by 2. We'll immediately trigger a new encounter without the possibility of running away. Receive 50 or to 60 natural mana. Let's follow them. But first, we'll try to figure out what kind of creatures are found here. Yes, follow them and retrieve this blood to use as magical ink. We'll immediately... Wow. Get a dungeon cloud, clarity. Celerity, rather. Of course we'll follow them. Let's go for it. A wounded traveling merchant is stuck amidst a group... Wargs are nothing but big dogs. Amidst a group of wargs. He is doing his best to keep them at bay, but is unlikely to last long. Let's help him. He'll surely reward us. 400 gold. Let's help him. He could probably trade us a few items for help. Get a dungeon card, old key. Ooh, I think that I would prefer. We'll give him a discount on adventure guild fees. Your reputation is at least 60 with the adventurer's guild. It's a lot of money. I don't suppose the wargs will eat gold. Oh, wow. I could just let him die and get everything. we'll help him get the items. Okay. Right. Start battle. In 10 turns, sudden death will start and characters will no longer be able to heal or gain shields. Sudden students who use the protection ritual will use the base magic bolt spell instead. This meter starts every battle. They've got 9, 9, 9. I think we're going to very quickly deal this. Jump. That, we critted it. Jump. Blood packed. Wow. Okay, that was good. Keep going. Yes, please. Let's have a look at these. So keys, we've got an old key. Keys collected. Cannot be played, but can be consumed by encounters. Allows a student to play twice during each combat round. Use this at the beginning of combat. Bark skin. Gives a student 2 armor points at the beginning of combat and for its whole duration. Forward! The question is either case. A Demi of Derp is what is in a Fanny Devil? It's a good question. Pentagram. On the floor in the middle of the corridor is a pentagram circled with candles. You'll have to cross it to continue. This is quite clearly a demonic summoning circle that demonologists love to use as security for the homes. Our students know a lot about demons. This will be a piece of cake. That's a shame we don't have that. Let's put up some runic protection. Also a shame we don't have. Well, it's got to be crossed. Let's turn around and find another way. Oh, well. Okay. Okay. Bit nasty, gonna be honest. Let's see how this goes. Punk. Okay, good. Managed to hold you up. Ouch. 8 damage, very nice. Oh, they've been... Oh, there we go, good. And they've been stunned. At this point, we should be able to get through this fairly easily. Blood Pact triggered. And they've been stunned again. Well, actually, no, they hadn't been stunned. They just got damaged. That's fine. Move forward. Mortuary Chamber. We're slightly low on health there, and they are, it looks like, bound. The vast hall is silent and dark, and its alcoves hold graves marked with runic symbols. In the room's center is an altar with offerings. Let's get the offerings. They must not be very useful. We'd have to fight 2 level 12 specters. No. Let's see what we can find in those graves. 4 level 12 specters. Also no. Let's not touch anything. We wouldn't want to disturb their sleep. That would have been good, dropping the threat level. But we could probably take on 2 specters, I guess. What do you say, chat? Take on 2 level 12 specters? Go big or go home. Okay. I wasn't going to jump into 4 level 12s because level 12 sounded pretty dangerous, but it's probably just their magic levels or something like that. I think we should easily be able to fight this specter. This dark spirit feeds off the energy of the living and builds up its own shield with each attack. It becomes enraged after 5 rounds, at which point it stops charging its shield, but it hits twice as hard. Does 5 damage each shot. If we're lucky... We're just going to be able to punch our way through. Yeah, I should have gone for the 4. We would have easily been able to handle it. The almost 50% chance we have of... In fact, you do have a 50% chance of doing double damage is just ridiculous in here. The danger meter fills after each encounter. The higher it is, the stronger the monsters. Encounters will become more difficult, but also give more loot. So many bloodstains in the area. Of course we'll follow them. Wounded traveling merchant is stuck amidst another group. Wow. I mean, I'll take another key, I guess, but I'd also kind of like the gold. Is it the same guy or a different one? That's a good point. I'll go for the gold this time. Those lucky crits are amazing. Oh wow, double hit. But healed straight back up. Rats, big ones at that. Currently devouring a pile of books and scrolls. Should we interrupt them? Let's save the scrolls. Let's save the spell books. They're simply too big. No, we're going to save the spell. Well, do we need another spell book in the... you know what? Yeah, I think we should get another spell book. The more of these we have, the better chance of all of our students being amazing at anything that they're learning. Looking forward to D&D today with my son. I invited him to my regular D&D group, and he's enjoying it thoroughly. I'm not sure he realized how much of a ham I am at the table. That sounds lovely, though. That being said, getting things that will allow me to survive in the dungeon probably is worth it. Tunk. 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 There we are, nice and easy. Trap corridor. Trap doors, poison darts, poisonous clouds! This corridor is filled with deadly traps. Moving through it will require great care. We shall retrace our steps and find another way. Our students are used to defusing traps. The group's total in assassination is of at least 8. Perfect. Keep going. A cute little dragon flutters at the end of the hall. It looks quite young. Catch it! Having a dungeon card, petrify. We'd get the blue dragon. Let's throw a golden key and see if it follows. Dragons love gold and playing catch. It's a well-known fact. Let's follow it to its nest. We might find more loot there. Well, cute little dragon nest. The cute dragon flutters across several halls until it arrives at a large room in which sits a gigantic pile of gold. On top, two large dragons guard three eggs. These parents don't seem happy. Attack! Boss battle. Ancient dragon. We could sing them to sleep with a druidic chant and steal their eggs. What? Green, white, and black dragon? Let's sneakily steal a bit of gold. They have plenty. They won't even notice. 940? I just want the gold. I want to, don't want to take their eggs. Raptor, poisonous darts. We'll get through that. Forward. Warg meal. A group of wargs are sharing the remains of a reckless adventurer. Thankfully, they haven't seen you. Be brave. Run away. Let's attack and give the unfortunate soul. Oh, good lord. Level 26. I am worried. That definitely escalated. Okay. They do 8 damage a pop now. Get rid of you. And I'm going to give you clarity. Tunk, tunk. There we go. There we are. Just wanted to make sure we got through that. Do we go on? We go on. Mad Mage's Laboratory. Smelly alembics, poison flask, blood vials, cauldrons filled with strange concoctions, creatures bits in a jar. The alchemists who live here have no limits to their experiments. Take their potions. Cultist level 20. Cultist level 20. Boss battle demon prince. I don't need that. I would kind of prefer the potions, frankly. How deep is the potion usually? I think they just keep going until you eventually decide, like, no. Well, Christoph, we're going to jump in. Okay, you're decently powerful. Barkskin on you. Barkskin on you. Clarity on you as well, because you're going to be amazingly powerful. All right, let's go. Tunk. Tunk. Okay, you didn't crit once, which is unfortunate. Ouch. Dead. Fairy Rip. Double dead! Depending on who it attacks next, we may win! No, we might not. Alas, our party is dead. Rip. Horse explored 11, but that was a pretty tough fight. We will know better in the future how to build up. Honestly, if I'd still had that finger of death to take out the cultist behind the demon, I feel that we would have won that one. Just taking out one of them would have been fine. I really do feel they were just adding a lot of damage, and because we couldn't get to them. But light magic probably would have been great there, yeah. However, we got 2,616 gold. 6 prestige points. 5 rep with the adventures, 5 rep with the kingdom. Goonie pig card, demonic chamber card, crypt card, alchemical reagent card, destructive potion card, demonic distillation card, and a bottled glory card. Ah. That's an average of 650 gold per child. These children wanted to go in there. It's true. I didn't force them. Oh, maybe I did. I don't know. But we came up with quite a lot of things. Goonie Pig improves the chances of achieving rare encounters when sending carrier Goonie Pigs. You will be in here. Goodbye, little Goonie Pig. But hey, Olivan, how are you doing? Avok, you killed your students. No, my students died. I didn't kill them. A demon prince killed them, and then the cultist killed them. I was powerless to stop them. So tragic. Demonic chamber. Let's get that upgraded. Dunk. Well, that's looking much more infernal. Infernal spellbook. Chaotic students learn faster. Studying this room has... I think we're going to wait for summoning forbidden. That's looking much better in there now. Right, this is the third upgrade, I believe, to crypt. Nice. Looking very snazzy. Really, it's reading a book. I could... Well, eventually we do want the mausoleum, but... Destructive potion greatly injures all attackers. Demonic potion, more mana. Bottle of glory, 5 prestige points, I accept. I will take the mana. I will take the alchemy points. Okay. And a Goonie Pig. I can't believe we've got this on. I should probably fix that now I'm actually generating light mana, thinking about it. I bring you some heretical artifacts. There you go. 100 shadow mana to increase your reputation with me. Hey, Avok. Doing good. Enjoying a cup of the dark brew and hating the world for still having summertime. Oh. I'm sorry, buddy. I hope your morning does continue to improve. That being said, it's not morning anymore. It's coming up to 1 p.m. I must say, chat, I think the test of the hardware is going quite well. Thank you so much, Argent Moore. Thank you for awesome content. I'm so glad to be able to support the channel. That's so kind of you to say. Diolch yn fawr iawn. Thank you very much for the 11 months as well. Hey, a long time since I caught a stream. Glad to see the Spellcaster University again. Yeah, I know, right? It's an amazing game. I wonder what the DLC is going to add. I could go Light Room, Shadow Room, Painting. Active characters in the room are bolstered by art, which reduces the growth rate of their needs for some time. Does this have room for art? I think it does, so we're going to pop a painting in there. Dunk. Couple of rooms will be improved. Private bedroom, psychologist, and student hall. I'm not sure we need more bedrooms, so we could get a better psychologist or we could improve the student hall. Honestly, I think the student hall being improved would be a better one. Look at that. Fancy chairs now and a mantelpiece. Arcane room, yes. We've been waiting for this for a while. Arcane room goes here, tonk. Alright, arcane teacher, Bill Nanny. Good pedagogy, light sleeper. Punctual, light sleeper. I think we're going to go with Bill. And you shall be Revenge. Reverend Enge. And there we are, we've spent all of our gold, just like that. Dear Lord. For this stage, I think we mostly have everything covered. Yeah, I think we've got one example of every single spell room. What build are we going for? No particular build, really. I'm not really sure there would be one, really. Child of Light over here. Let's go for that. Only one person this time. Totem. Active students in this room slightly improve their druidism skill. Active characters in this room lose a bit of tiredness. I think we're going to just increase our stable. At this point, it's now got an efficiency of plus 38%. 1,000 more cheese and sleeper souls. That's rather expensive, though. Yikes. Right, the Army of Darkness has now crossed the 50% threshold. Might need to go and talk with the king. Get them to send out their forces again. Necrostaff. When a student is at least level 2 necromancy, they have a necrostaff. They now produce 30% more shadow mana. Yes, please. Hello, Zoffin. It's Spellcaster University. Glad to see you. Well, I'm glad you're happy to see you, mate. It makes me very glad. This is a fantastic game that honestly hasn't had... Well, recently it has had a bit more coverage, but for the longest time, like, it didn't seem that many people even knew it existed. Let's get in there. We want to try and slow this down. My school is perfectly equipped. Ooh, we could take the vampires. A bunch of new students wouldn't be terrible. Yeah, all right. New students. Lawful good, allergic to crustaceans. I forget where we need to send you. Well, it's definitely not there. I'll pop you there. Diligent, chatty. You're only going to be here for 3 years. We'll pop you in Leafbeard. Beautiful, hypochondriac, coward. We should probably retool Vimes as well now. Chosen by the light. Passionate, hypochondriac, demoralized. We'll pop you in Jackal. On that note, let's have a look. Do we want to change out Vimes a bit? I'm not really sure if there is much reason to. In fact, I could have these three just focus on a certain role, but not eliminate anyone. But this does afford me a place to put people so they don't go into roles the way they'd have an allergy. Yeah, Armok is a Dwarf Fortress reference, yep. How's classroom capacity? It's doing quite... Oh, wait, have you got mushroom growing out of your head? Looking dapper. You do. Loses a little health over time. Has a very small chance to disappear. Or can be cured in the infirmary. Arcane mushroom growing out of your nose. What the... Don't even. I don't even. Alchemy Apprentice. We'll pop you in Hyde. Or, I mean, I guess, in Vimes. Though, really, I should stop throwing everyone into Vimes now, because it's not going to necessarily help me anymore. I want to try and spread people out a bit more. Get the various other disciplines being worked on. We are actually reasonably high on the number of beds. We orcs don't need much, and what we need we can take from the weak humans. On the other hand, you could just give us things. Our alchemists can craft what you need. Also, let's put you back to sleep. Adventurers Guild increase. Yeah, I think the next time we are going to go and speak with the king and ask the king to attack the army and drive it back by 3%. If we can manage that, I'll be very happy. New house, but I don't really think we need one. So instead, let's get another dormitory, because as I just mentioned, we are actually starting to look like we've got too many. Could perhaps build over the greenhouse. It is an option. But I think... Well, either that or I get... We've got 4 dormitories. Do I need another dormitory is the question. Zofin, I'll explain my strategy in just a second. Just trying to decide where to place this. You know what? I think I'm going to invest it in just making this one a little bit more efficient. Earthins. Instantly makes it more efficient. Right, so the way that I set up the houses. Initially, my first house was simply a better general class because it had diligent worker. And I specifically chose two talents rather than magical school affinities. And they were completely even. Until I got my first quest, and then I set up my quest house for that quest, which was initially going to be Child of Nature, but I ended up with Alchemy Apprentice. I didn't have Child of Nature, so I decided, okay, well, since I could either pick either one of these to be the quest house then, I set this one up for Alchemy, and I set it to allow... initially, it just didn't allow Nature, and had a priority on Alchemy, and then the other three were represented, but this one was switched over to Nature, and I disallowed everything else. So that covered my curriculum, which is to get Rangers, which only required a very low level of Nature. I think it was Beast Magic. And also I had my Mana quest, the 8,000, being Nature Magic. So that's why I pretty much made this one exclusively Nature. And then over time, I got a couple of others. Once I'd had a dungeon offered to me, I set up a dungeon house. And I pretty much focus on Shadow and Nature for that one, with Shadow as a priority, just to get my combat skills up in that. And with Nature then, so we'd have a little bit of herbalism, just for a little bit of extra healing on that one. But then once I, because for the longest time I didn't have light magic, once I did have light magic, I added in a little bit of light there as well, just so that we could perhaps top it up with some light skills. And as I've been going, I've been redistributing the requirements, mostly to allow me to always have a house that has certain disallowed fields of study. It's less a case that I'm trying to make houses that specifically focus on certain fields as I am trying to make houses into which I can safely put people who don't do well in certain areas of study. This one then was pretty much I ended up with Arcane Scholar and Alchemy. After a certain point, I was like, okay, well, I'll take a new house and I'll just see what I get. And this one had a possibility for a double specialist. So this is why this one is literally just them. And everything else is forbidden. And then I got a final house once I'd completed this quest. And I decided, okay, well, we'll see what we get. And I actually had Child of Nature. So this one became the nature-focused house. And Comical, because Comical is just such a good trait to have. Though it would be much better if I had more people in it, because then I'd have more instances of people walking around the school with Comical and keeping people's boredom down. Something I should, I will bear in mind and try and fill that out a bit more. But at that point, I just adjusted this one, because initially I was going to make this one a light school, because I only recently gotten any light buildings. But given that I had the option for Child of Nature here and Chosen by Light, I decided to make this one a Child of Nature one, and then just allow this one to be light, because I really wanted Comical, and that was on the row with the Chosen by Light attribute. Just double check. Oh, yeah. That's right. I popped them in there because I wasn't sure which one to pop them into. I think I'm going to pop them down here because I just want to avoid crustaceans, which is alchemy, so they should do well in there. Vimes? Question mark. You'll need to use more words in your question for me to know what I'm answering. Yes, or you'll expose yourself to people being smart asses and just respond with Vimes! demonic. Increasing demonology or prison? I think we're going to go with prison. Oh, yeah. We've now got a little kit. Oh, we've got a skeleton added in there with a shackle and everything. Oh, that's brilliant. I approve. I can now go for indoctrination if I really wanted to. But I actually don't care to make them lawful. I wouldn't mind getting Inquisition techniques, though. Ooh. Unicorn horn. Tonk. Void portion. Closes all portals and extinguishes all fires. So that would be useful if we suddenly had a bunch of aberrations. Oh. There's an imp! When did you get here? Imp is very angry. I have never noticed them actually summon anything. That is amazing. Truly. Inquisition banner. There we go. That will do instead. Let's pop that in there. And at this point, we're passively increasing our reputation with pretty much everyone. Hello, did you know the neighboring school gives scholarships? I do. But, yeah, sure. We'll take werewolves. Don't need another goon pig, but alchemical talisman would be nice to get some more mana. And we'll go ahead and Lord of Evil, I think. I'm just going to increase our standing with the Lord of Evil for now. Right, let's get a couple of you. Passionate, demonized, slow, here for 7 years. A bit slow, though. Let's pop you in Leaf Beard. Well-behaved, voracious, antisocial, well-off, a bit slow. Wow, two bit slows. Courageous, shifty. I'm not going to pop you in Vimes, just because that's over full right now. Down-to-earth, hypochondriac. I think it is going to have to be Vimes there. Chosen by light. There we go. And diligent. We'll pop you in here because it'll be double diligent then. Comical down here. Double comical. And again. Wow. Allergic to crustaceans. I'm fairly certain the leaf beard. I mean, I'll double check that though. I think leaf beard had alchemy. Yeah. Good. There we are. Done and done and done. Went to school in Europe and we didn't have prisons, but now that I think of it, we probably should have. I don't know. Oh my lord. What have I done? There's an awful lot of people. An awful lot of people. New deep folk. Start recruiting 5 students with a deep folk trait. Or, when a student is at least level 3 in elementalism and level 2 in enchantment, they get an arcane crystal staff. They now learn all magic 25% faster. That is absolutely worth having. We got a shapeshifter. Oh my lord, you got a lot of things. Okay. Where is shapeshifter on this? Right there. We've got demon hunter, magic teacher, unicorn handler, shapeshifter, librarian, and scholar. I'll go with shapeshifter, sure. Let's keep increasing druidism. Ranger, new. Shapeshifter, yes. Warlock, increases demonology learning by 1%. Very nice. Village mage, no, we can do better than that. Ritual priest, wasn't what I was aiming for, but sure. Gardener, nope. Cemetery Guardian. Gain 10 gold each time you interact with the Lord of Evil. I mean, not terrible. Yes, Light Sleeper trait is very nice. I think we'll just accept that one. Minion. No, let's roll that again. Okay, that Fate spoke and wanted you to be a minion. Imp, reduce the cost. Wizard Apprentice. Let's try for Craftsman. Yeah. Not terrible, that one. We actually got a stupid amount of items there. We could increase the crypt, the janitor's lodge. Active characters in this room have a chance of becoming bad and earning the trait that allows them to learn shadow magic faster. I think I would prefer the janitor's lodge. Right now we've got 2 janitors, but I'm going to improve this one. Let's have a quick look at what it looks like. And boom! Close the line. Pinnacle of technology. Another ivy wouldn't be a bad one. Improving our stable also wouldn't be a bad one. Currently we've got an ivy there, and that's improving efficiency around the place. If we have a look, we could have an ivy down here for much the same effect. Or we could just improve the stable. I think we're going to go with ivy. There would hit all of these.